G'day. We're after the Viking for Ultimate Adventure Fishing interview.
Yeah, and that would be me.
Where's your captain?
That would also be me. We had this appointment, I'm going to do this live feed. That's
yeah,
me.
That's you. The way we fish and the way she fish, she calls us hobby fishermen.
My God. You? Okay. Okay, you want to go there, don't we? You guys are kind of weird. You release the fish, don't know why, what's the point of it?
Have you ever come close to dying out there? And how many people on your boat?
Right now it's just me. But before I had my own boat, I worked as a crew for years. So I had to go to further south in the northern part of Norway, called Troms and Nordland, and had to stay there for months at a time. It's very far away from home. And obviously, Mr. Walker here does not know what a fishing boat is.
I showed her the old black pig, and she said, "What is that?"
Yeah, that's not what we call fishing boats. And that day, it was supposed to be storm. That's fine. It sucks, but it's fine. Now comes the part where we almost died.
Okay.
This was just a normal day. This was just a normal day. We ran like hell. We had to find a knife and just cut off our own nets to make it, because in a second the boat was standing like this. So I was hanging on to something. We all were hanging on to something. So I was hanging on to something, and I could see my feet just straight down in the water because the boat was like this. So it was pretty intense. You were all just hanging on. And we managed to cut the nets and check the propellers real fast to see if we were able to make it out of there alive or not. And luckily for us, we managed to cut it before it was too stuck in the propeller not to work. So we could just cut the nets, say, "Oh, well, we survived, that's good." And then we had to go to the next net we had out in the sea and continue to work. And the day after, we went back and had to search for the net we had to cut off to be able to save the nets. So, yeah, shit like that happens.
She had a bit of trouble with getting there. So
the transport disappeared.
The transport disappeared, but anyway, keep going.
So that's what we do. It's halibut, king crab, and cod mainly.
What's the coldest temperature that you fish in? What's the coldest you fished in?
And I think the time I went out there in the hurricane, that was the coldest. That was the coldest.
How do you say crikey, mate?
Crikey, mate.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Crikey. Oh, calm down. Crikey.
Good
crikey.
Use of the word crikey.
And every time I have to...
Good note.
You are lucky sons of bitches. This is called Yuxa machine. That's the machine that's doing the fishing for me, actually. So, there's this kind of line, like this. You can see it. And I have lots of hooks attached to it. And release the fish from the hooks, kill it, and throw it in one of these. A lot of these. And also underneath the deck, under this thing, there's a storage room for fish. So this boat right now can take about 2 tons of fish.
Oh my God.
I just gotta do some real girl stuff, like this. This is the batteries, and I don't think anything is missing right now. I hope not.
What about those ones?
These ones, I never managed to figure out what they were about, so I just don't know what they were. I hope I didn't forget anything.
No.
Ha 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 ha
bags. Yes, I forgot to check the obvious place, which is the garage. I didn't think about it. And did I feel stupid? Yes.
United
did I think
States,
about not telling you? Yes.
North Korea.
Should I have not told you? Yes.
So, when are you coming over?
Well, when do you want me to come over?
Oh, you can come and challenge us whenever you like. Whenever you think you're ready.
Well, the challenge is on. And I think it's best that you guys come up here, let's say March, April, because then it will be hell for you and it will be really fun for me. So, it's the worst season. And it's a lot of fun.
So, a hobby fisherman can't sell fish, so there's not a lot of point to keeping them. You've got what you need to eat.
Thank you for saying that. You just said hobby fishers. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
We call ourselves recreational fishers here.
Potato, potato, right? But thank you, and I look forward to kicking your asses. And to the good people watching, you should also watch, because that will be fun. Okay, so I'll talk to you later.
Yeah. Big thanks, Sandra. And yeah, we'll talk to you soon.
Yeah. Good luck.
Cheers.